that good that he came to die for you and I? Amen. God's Son and our Savior. Amen. The night heaven kissed earth for you and I. I'm thankful for a baby boy that was born. Amen. And I thank God for that. I thank God that he left the portals of glory to come here just to save me. Amen. If I'd have been the only one here, he would have died for me. And I thank God for that. What a beautiful job by the choir. They sang those last week, and I'd ask them to sing them again today to start off our worship service today. And I'm thankful for that. We're going to sing a lot of songs before we get out of here today and have a good time in the Lord. Listen, Ed, we're here to celebrate his birth. Amen. And so we're going to do that today. I realize Christmas Day is tomorrow, but this is Christmas Eve, and we're going to have a good time in the Lord. We're going to start by prayer today. And so if you want to come and gather in the altar for a time of prayer, you can come pray with us today. But we're going to pray and beg God to help us and use us for just a little while this morning. Lord, we love you. And God, we sure do. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness and for your grace today. God, thank you, Lord, for mercy today. Thank you for loving us. God, thank you, Lord, for sending your Son, as I've already said, and our Savior. God, for the sins of the world. Father, that we may have life and have life eternal. And Father, we are privileged, we are honored, we are blessed to be in this place today where we can worship you. And God, we can adore you and we can serve you today. And God, we mean to do that very thing. I pray today that we leave here today, that everything that's said and done, God, you'd get the glory. And Father, we could all leave saying it's been good to be in the house of God, knowing that we have magnified a holy God today and our Savior Jesus Christ. Father, we love you today. We thank you for what you've done for us this week, how you have kept us and used us, Lord, just for your glory. Now bless everyone, Lord, that's around this altar today. Lord, whatever prayer requests they may have, I pray, God, you'd meet it in a mighty way for the sick. Father, we pray, Lord, you'd heal them, touch them. Lord, lift them up today. Give them a speedy recovery. Father, give them healing today. And Father God, I pray, Lord, your touch be upon them, Lord, in every way possible. Do what the doctors cannot do, Lord, in their life. We're thankful for doctors and modern medicine and technology. And Lord, all of those things, we thank you, Lord, for how you've blessed. But there's nothing like the touch of God, Lord, when we're sick. And so touch those that could not be with us today for whatever the reason might be for sickness. Lord, in health, God, I pray, Lord, just get them back to us soon and safe. Lord, use us today. Lord, while we're here, that you might be magnified through us through the preaching of the word today. I pray, God, you'd help me say every word that needs to be said. Father, hold us back from any word that should not be said in this place this morning. If there's one here that's lost and undone, I pray, Father, you'll save them before it's eternally too late. They'll be drawn to this altar by the good Spirit of God this morning. And Father, they'd come and get salvation before it's too late for them. Lord, help us, Lord, to be your servant today. Touch every family that's in here today, regardless of what they're going through. And Father, bless them, and we hold them up to you today. Bless our missionaries throughout the land. Bless pastors and churches today. God, throughout this land, throughout this country, wherever they are, God, we pray, Lord, your will be done completely, Lord, in their life. Help this nation today, Lord, as a whole. Guide us in the right direction. God, the nation of Israel today, and the Lord, the leaders there, help them in the war, in the midst of the war they're in, the nation of Ukraine. Father, we beg you to help them and bless them and strengthen them. Help us to celebrate your birth today, Lord, as our Savior. And Lord, we'll thank you, we'll love you, God, for what you've done for us. And Father, all that you will do, we praise you for it right now. We ask all these things in Christ's wonderful name. And all God's children said, well, amen. It is good to see you in the house of the Lord this morning. Appreciate the good number here today. Pray for a lot of our people that are not here today. There is sickness everywhere. Amen. And they can't be here today with us. And they would sure love to be. Some of you have been sick, and I pray, praise the Lord, you're over it and through it and got on this side of it. Amen. But they need our prayers today. So pray for them through this Christmas holiday, that even through it all, they may get to enjoy the Christmas season. During this time, several things I want to remind you of today. There'll be no service here tonight, and so you'll be off to go enjoy your Christmas time with your family tonight, enjoy your Christmas day tomorrow, and then also those of us going on the mission trip, continue to pray for that, and those that are going. I think everybody's pretty much in order that is going. We will settle those dates here, hopefully within the next couple of weeks of when we'll be leaving here and going out, so pray much for us there. Elliot and Kaylee Shower coming up on the 20th. Don't forget that here at the church. And it's already been mentioned this morning, your Bible reading schedules. If you'd like to have one, there in the back on the table back there, there's some there. If we run out, we'll get you some more. And so grab one of those for your Bible reading this coming year. Let me say this too, for any of you that may want to go, Chris and I were going to announce this the other day and I forgot. Kenneth Baldwin is going to be at Belmont Baptist Church in Burlington next Saturday at 5 o'clock. They have a youth rally there. And for any of you youth that would like to go, to Brother Nathaniel Hobbs Church there. And so you'd like to go to that. I know you'd enjoy it, Brother Kenny. I'm going to try to be there if I possibly can next Saturday afternoon. I'd love to be there with them. And so if you'd like to go to that, don't mark that down on your calendar. And you can go and have a good time. Also, there are Christmas cards downstairs. It's laid out on the counter down there. They're separated. Go down there and look and see. You may have a Christmas card down there. So if you want to go and check and see if your name is on one of them, grab it. They're all laid out down there for you. So get them before you leave today. If you don't get them, I'm going to get them, and I'm going to get all the cards out of them and everything and use them. Amen. I'm just kidding. Amen. But go down and get them today. We'd appreciate that. Okay. All right. Anything else today that we may know of? Brandon? We're going to get some birthdays in a minute, some anniversaries. I know they got a ladies' Super Sunday next Sunday, so don't forget that for all you ladies at 9:30 next Sunday morning, and we'll look forward to that. Okay. Anything else today? All right, let's go ahead. I'll tell you what, we'll go ahead and do our birthdays and anniversaries today. We do have some birthdays and anniversaries we want to try to do. And listen, at the end of this birthday thing today, we're going to sing happy birthday to Jesus because we do celebrate his birth at this time. So if you have a birthday or an anniversary, you just had one, a fixing to have one, an anniversary, then we want you to come on up. Amen. And so you come today. Xavier's got a birthday. Amen. Or had a birthday, one or the other. Brother Kim and Miss Kat, they had an anniversary. Amen, right? 27th. The 27th, they had a, oh, y'all having it on the 27th. On the 27th, they have an anniversary. How many years? 37 years. I got him during this supper, for the Christmas supper, and I said, all the seniors from 60 years old can come on up and eat, and Miss Kathy had to sit there and let him go eat. And I went by the table, and I said, it's tough to be married to an old man, isn't it? Amen? And so we know how that, Jane knows how that is, Miss Kathy. She feels your pain. Y'all got an anniversary? How many years? 16. 16. Amen. How'd you do it, Brother Roth? I'm just kidding. Amen. Amen. All right. They got an, anybody else today? Miss Carla Rose have something? Miss Carla Rose, come on up, girl. Got a birthday? You better get up here so we can sing to you. I know you're proud of it. All right. All right. Let's all stand and sing. Let's sing happy birthday first. Thank the Lord for that. Miss Charlie, if you would come on up. Mr. Cole, y'all come up today. Ushers, if you would come on up today. We're going to take our morning offering. And while we're taking our offering today, Miss Charlie is going to sing one for us while we're doing that today. And in just a little bit, all of us are going to get in on some singing. Amen. We're going to have a good time in here today. But you come and you give today as given unto the Lord. And while they're getting ready, Brother Josh, if you would take us, Lord, in prayer today, bud. Yes.
And Lord, I pray you would be with us today during this service as we celebrate his life and the life that he gave to us. And Lord, I pray, Lord, you would take this offering, Lord. Pray that you would bless it and multiply for your work, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. Amen. Listen to Miss Charlotte sing today. Thank you.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Isn't that sweet? Thank the Lord. I'm glad it's his birth today. Listen, if you have your Bibles today, turn to Luke chapter number 1. And I'm going to preach to you today what God's laid upon my heart for this day. I've been preaching this month. And let me just say this before I get started. The whole congregation is going to get involved in the message through the singing today, okay? And so we want you singing in just a little bit. We've got certain songs that we're going to sing. We'll be calling them out to you. They are in your hymn book. And so at the end of the service, there's a song in that green book, red book, blue book, whatever you got in the back of the pew there. There's a song in there that we're going to sing all the way through. Most of them we're just going to, all but the verse, and we're going to sing a couple of verses. Some of them we're only going to sing one verse, but Michael and Brother Joey's going to come up here and help me out in just a little bit. I told you guys for the last couple of weeks that we were coming to worship and adore him today. Amen? And that's exactly what we plan to do, is to adore him and worship him and magnify him today. And I pray that it'll be a blessing to you, but I want you to get involved. I don't want to be the only one that gets to worship today. I want you to worship also, and you to adore him today. He's worthy of it. I will tell you that, and I pray that we'll help to you to get you in that mood today, or in that mode today, before we get started. And so this week I was praying and just begging God. You know, we've been talking about for the whole month, we've been preaching on I Want to Be More in 2024. And we preached some great, great messages, not because I preach them, just because they're from the Word of God already this year, and I thank God for that. And we preached last week on not stopping too short, amen? We can't stop short of the promise of God, I will tell you that. And so we don't want to stop short of getting everything that God has for us in 2023. We're not planning to do that today. And so I'm going to give you what God's laid upon my heart for this day. As I was reading this week and just begging God and praying over and over and over, even Wednesday night, I had no idea what I was going to preach today. As of Wednesday night, I've just been begging God all week long for that one thought. God, give me that one thought. I want to magnify you with a great thought. And God began to work on my heart through much prayer and showed me some things here in the Word of God. So I want to start reading this morning in Luke chapter number 1, verse number 26 this morning. And I'm going to read down through verse number 38 and then preach the message that God's laid on my heart. And during the message, at certain times in the message, I'm going to stop and we're going to sing. Amen? And so if you don't get in today and worship God, it's going to be your problem and not mine. Amen? Because we're going to sing and adore him and worship him through some songs today and have a great time in the Lord. And they'll all line up with the message and what I'm about to preach here. You'll see that in just a minute. But verse number 26 in Luke chapter number 1, Mary here is meeting with the angel Gabriel, and he's about to bear tidings of the greatest news that was ever delivered to mankind. Amen. That is the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And the Bible says in verse 26, and in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou art highly favored. The Lord is with thee. Because blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. I'm thankful God put that in there. Amen. I'm glad that he didn't die when he died. Amen. Amen. He just, listen, went to the grave for a few days, rose right back up. And I thank God for that. And I'm glad it's still available today, just like it was then. Verse 34, then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man. She says, I've never laid down with a man before. How in the world could this be? Verse 35 says, The angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month with her, who was called barren. Listen to this. For with God nothing shall be impossible. For with God nothing shall be impossible. And I want you to look at verse number 38, because here's where I'm going to take my message from today. I read all of that to just give you some insight on what's taking place. And the Bible says here in verse 38, and Mary said this, behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Be unto me according to thy word. I've already said we see Mary here meeting with the angel Gabriel here. He's the bearer of glad tidings here in the word of God. And he's bearing and bringing the best news that could have ever been delivered to mankind on this earth down here. But that there was a Savior that was going to be born. His name was going to be Jesus. Amen. He's going to be called Emmanuel. Listen, she was very troubled over that at this time. She was very confused on how this was going to take place. And Gabriel here began to give her great comfort into how this was going to take place. He said the power of the Holy Ghost is going to overshadow you. Listen, this is typology of salvation right here. Also, if you look at it here, according to the word of God, that the Holy Ghost is going to overshadow her, and she was going to be with child. And then he goes on to tell her to expect a miracle. He says, Mary, I need you to expect a miracle here from God. Listen, for you and I today, we ought to expect the miracles of God every day in our life. Amen. And I can tell you this today, if you're saved, you're a miracle today. If I'm saved, I'm a miracle today. Listen, just because I'm preaching the word of God, I can tell you now, there's a miracle that took place just to get to preach the word of God. But he told Mary here, listen, for with God nothing shall be impossible. And I need you to expect a miracle in this, because you can't understand it. Amen. I got word from God, and I'm here to tell you that God sent me here. The Holy Ghost is going to overshadow you. I don't know how it's going to take place. Amen. I understand God said you're a virgin, but you're going to be with child. Amen. And you're going to be full of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And you're going to bear a son here, and you need to accept and expect that miracle that's taking place in your life. And Mary begins to rejoice here in verse 38 after God told her all these things. And here's what she said, be it unto me according to thy word. In other words, she said, God, whatever it is you need to do, do it. Whatever I need to do, I'll do it. Whatever your will is, Lord, I surrender fully to you at this time. I'm all yours and you're all mine, and whatever it takes, listen, if you're going to do it, go ahead and do it. I am good with everything that's taking place. And I begin to think about this from Thursday on through Thursday and Friday and yesterday and even this morning in my office for a good while, and I jotted down several things here I believe that happened to Mary at this time. And I'm going to preach to you on this thought today. Don't forget the thought. When we get what Mary got. When we get what Mary got, amen. Just remember that during the preaching today. When we get what Mary got, I looked at some things that Mary here began to do when she got what she got from the Lord. And she said, be it unto me, do whatever you're going to do. I'm yours, this body's yours, take it, do as you please, God, I'm all in. And listen, do what you got to do. Listen, I find here that she begins to surrender to a personal Savior. When she got what she got, she surrendered to a personal Savior. He wasn't just any God at this time. She said here in the verses 46 through 48, she said, my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. Amen. Mary begins to rejoice here. She said, my soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior, for he hath regarded me of low estate. And listen, she begins here to surrender her life to a personal Savior. The Holy Ghost of God had overshadowed her at this time, and we find Mary completely surrendered. Listen, I begin to look at Mary's life this week and to think about her life and who she was. And if there's one person in life that I would think, why in the world would she have to surrender to a holy God? Look at her life. Look at her lifeline of the line of David. Amen. But I found out this in God's word. It don't matter where you came from. It don't matter what your last name is. Amen. It don't matter how much money you got. Amen. It don't matter if your granddaddy started the church. Amen. It don't matter if your grandmother bought the pews in the church. It don't matter that their name's on the window. Amen. Hey, it don't matter who it is in the community. Listen, when it comes to God, listen, if Mary had surrendered to a personal Savior, it's going to be up to you and I to surrender to a personal Savior. You can't get in any other way. Your name's not going to get you there. Your heritage is not going to get you there. The line that you came from is not going to get you there. We're going to have to humble before a holy God, amen, and bow our heads and rejoice that there is a personal Savior and surrender to Him in our life. It did not matter that she was from the line of David, amen. It did not matter, listen to this, that she had lived a pure life. Listen, the Bible said that I cannot believe that Jesus, that God would use anybody to do anything in the name of Jesus that was not pure to send His Son through. She had lived a pure life. She had lived a clean life. And listen, I thank God for those that live a clean life. I thank God for young ladies that grow up. You young ladies, listen to me, that grow up and live a clean life. I thank God for young men to grow up and live a clean life. And you ought to do everything that you can to try to do that, amen. You ought to try to get married when you're pure, amen. You ought to do things right in the sight of God. Listen, her pure life ain't what got her in, amen. What got her in is she surrendered to a personal Savior. Amen. Listen, He was God, her Savior. I thank God for a pure life, but it's not what's going to get us in. You say, preacher, I've been clean all my life. I've been in Sunday school all my life. I've been in church all my life. Listen, you can go sit in the garage for the next 30 years too, and it ain't going to make you a car, amen. You can sit in the church all your life, and it ain't going to make you a Christian. I don't care how clean we are. Listen, without His cleansing, we'll never get in, amen. But she surrendered here to a personal Savior, amen. And I thank God for that. She had a clean life, but it wouldn't get her in. She was of the right lineage, but it would not get her in. I find her here meeting with an angel, amen. Talking to an angel, but it would not get her in. I find her here, listen, I believe she had the Holy Ghost on her, preacher. I really do. I find in the story when she, the Bible says here that she went to visit her cousin Elizabeth that was pregnant with John the Baptist. And the Bible said when Mary walked in and spoke, John the Baptist leaped in her womb and was filled with the Spirit of God. At that time, here's a woman that was filled with the Holy Ghost before her time. But listen, she had to take her place. She had to bow her knee. She had to humble herself and look up and said, listen, He is my personal Savior. I'm going to surrender Him and nothing else. I'm not surrendering to the church. I'm not surrendering to the Baptist. I'm not surrendering to the Methodist. I'm not surrendering to a preacher. I'm going to surrender to a holy God. He's going to be my personal Savior. He is my Spirit. He is my God. And she surrendered to a holy God at that time. I'm going to tell you something, friend, today. If you're going to get in, it's going to take surrender to a personal Savior. We're going to sing this old song we've not sang in a long time. Michael, you and Brewer Joe, come on up. I surrender all. Listen, here's how you can worship Him today. And it may just start right here. Listen, if we don't sing another song, I don't care. If God floods this altar, I don't care. It's up to God. But here's how you're going to do more for God in 24, amen? Is we're going to have to surrender to a personal Savior. We're going to have to give it all to God. You're going to have to realize that you didn't get in because of who you were. You're going to have to realize that you didn't get in and I didn't get in because of my family. I can only get in when I surrender to God. So let's all stand this morning. Here's our worship to Him this morning. As I surrender all. What page are we on this morning? Page 354 in your hymnals this morning. Page 354. Let's sing the first and last verse of this, Michael. First and last verse, I surrender all. Get in right here and worship Him this morning. and I pray you mean that today. Listen, if you want to glorify God today, amen, you want to magnify Him, we're going to have to surrender all to Him. Amen. It don't matter where we come from. It don't matter how sorry we were. It don't matter how good we were. Amen. It does not matter the family line we come from. It does not matter how much money you came out of or how much poverty you came out of. Amen. If we're going to get in, we're going to get in because we surrendered to Him. I find when I look at Mary's life that she surrendered all to a personal Savior. Not only that, I find in Mary's life, you listen to this, I find her shouting the praises of a powerful Savior. I find her shouting the praises of a powerful Savior. As I begin to look at the Word of God here, and I'm going to give you several of these just for sake of time this morning and not go real deep into them because we're going to sing some more songs in honor of His praise today. I find in verse 48, she praised Him for His love. She praised Him for His love. She says, for He hath regarded the low estate of His handmaid. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed. She not only praised Him for His love, she praised Him for His favor. Listen, if you ain't got anything else you can praise God today for, you ought to praise Him for His love. That He sent His only God Son to die for you, you can have life and have life eternal. That He gave you the opportunity to be saved, amen. Listen, and that we found favor in His sight. If you're in here today, listen, you're saved, you found favor in His sight. When He died, listen, when He came and died, we found favor in His sight. And so we find Mary here praising Him for His love. We find her praising Him for His favor. I love what verse 49 says. She praised Him for His might. Amen. I'm glad I serve a mighty God today. Amen. I'm glad I don't serve some weak God today. I don't serve a sissy God today. Amen. Listen, can I tell you this? Humility has nothing to do with weakness. I want you to understand that. Humility has everything to do with strength. He humbled Himself and came to a lowly earth for you and I in humility, friend, that He may be, they may have, give us great courage in life. So humility here does not mean He was weak. Listen, He had His might. The Bible says in verse 49, for He that is mighty hath done these things. Yes. I'm glad I serve a mighty God today. I'm glad I can adore and worship a mighty God today. Listen, we live in a generation today where Christians and churches out there today, you would think they serve somebody standing in a bread line somewhere. Amen. Listen, everybody's gloom and doom, and Jesus is not doing this, and the church can't do this, and the church can't. Hey, I don't care what they say the church can't do. The Bible says we can. Amen. We can have victory in Jesus. Amen. We can surrender all. Listen, we can have the glory of God. We can have the joy of salvation. I realize we're sitting around here this morning like we eat a bunch of sour grapes or a bunch of sour plums. I fully understand that, but that's your fault, not God's fault. Amen. God said, listen, God's given it all to us. We're here to adore Him and to worship Him today. If you want the joy of your salvation today, we're going to have to praise Him for His might. And then she began to praise Him for His mercy. I thank God for His mercy on my soul. Amen. I was a sinner. Amen. Had to be saved by God's grace. And God was merciful to me where I was. He found me in a lowly place. And I thank God that He did. I'm glad He came to where I was when I couldn't get to where He was at. Amen. Listen, I thank God for His grace. And I praise Him for His mercy. I praise Him for His might today. Now, I don't let it. I praise Him for His grace today. The Bible says in verse number 52, He hath put down the mighty from their seats and exalted them of low degree. Amen. I'm glad that He'll go where the slum is. Amen. I'm glad that He'll go to the depths of the earth and get us when we're no count. We think we're not worthy. And listen, everybody else around us thinks we're not worthy either. But there's a God up in heaven that loves us enough to send His only begotten Son to die for us, friend. Listen, He'll come down to those of low degree and pick us up. So she praised Him for His grace. And then in verse 53, she praised Him for His goodness. I'm glad He's a good God today. You know why you're here today? Because of the goodness of God. Listen, there's a lot of folks laying at home sick this morning. There's a lot of them laying in the hospital today. There's a lot of them laying in the grave today. You ought to thank God just for His goodness. He'd give you enough grace to get up this morning, get out of the house. You ought to thank God He woke you up this morning. I was praying for all of you this morning. I said, God, if there's one that's not coming, convict them, prick them while they're in the bed. I pray that the bed turn over in the house. I pray that the TV blow up. I pray that the heat blow up in the house and get cold and I have to get out and go somewhere. Listen, I prayed every prayer I could pray this morning. God, fill our house. Do what you have to do. I don't care if they got to go home to a broken TV. That's their problem and not yours. Amen. Listen, I just prayed God get you here. So we ought to praise Him for His goodness this morning. You say, well, the only reason I came this morning, Brother Mike, you don't know this, but my TV blowed up this morning. I couldn't say, good, I'm glad. Amen. Now you ought to ask God to get you another one if you need it. Don't use it on his time. Hallelujah. Amen. Listen, we serve a good God today. I find Mary praising him, shouting praises to a powerful Savior. Not some weak Savior. I'm talking about to a powerful Savior. Praise him for his love. Praise him for his favor. Praise him for his might. Praise him for his mercy. Praise him for his grace. And praise him for his goodness. Now, we're going to get a chance to praise him today also. Mike, don't you all come? Y'all come today. Listen, grab your books today, your hymnals today. We're going to start at page 388 and sing a verse of O Come All Ye Faithful. And then we're going to 408 and sing Hark the Herald Angel. Then we're going to sing Joy to the World. Listen, it's your opportunity to praise him right now. Listen, you ought to have something in your life that you can praise God for today. There ought to be something God's done for you just to get you up and get you here this morning. You say, I'm going to praise him. I'm going to sing his praises. I'm going to sing, oh, come all ye faithful. Thank God that he came, amen. Listen, I'm going to sing Joy to the World, amen. I'm glad that he's here. Listen, sing the song to praise this morning. Come on, lead us, Michael.
Amen. 388, oh, come all ye faithful. Flip over to 408. 408, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Stay there and go to the top of the page at 408, Joy to the World. We'll do the first verse on that.
Seated, amen. Listen, we ought to find something we can praise the Lord for, amen. There ought to be something in our life. It ought to be a joy. When you get what Mary got, listen to me, when you get what Mary got, trust me, you're gonna surrender to a personal Savior, amen. When the Holy Ghost of God overshadows you the way that he did Mary, and he comes upon you, listen, and meets with you, the chances are you're going to surrender to a personal Savior, amen. And not only that, you're going to start to praise a powerful Savior. You're going to realize how great he is in your life. You're going to realize how merciful he was to you, amen, to find you where you were. You're going to realize how mighty he was to pull you out of the dark hole that you were in when God finished. Listen, you're going to find out how great it is for him just to love us. I don't know about y'all, but listen, I wasn't the most loved person probably growing up, amen. I made some mistakes along the way, and mama had a bunch of little snotty-nosed boys that were mean, amen, ugly, mean as snakes running around everywhere out there. Listen, and somebody had to love us, amen. And I'm thankful to somebody that loved me, amen. Listen, he loved me more than my mama ever loved me. I'm thankful for the love of my mama. She's sitting here this morning, but my mama ain't never loved me like Jesus loved me, amen. My mama couldn't save me. As a matter of fact, if she could have saved me, she would have saved me from the world and the trouble I was headed to in life, but she couldn't keep me at the house. I was too stubborn and too rebellious and too hard-headed and ran out of the house. But God up above, I thank God he watched every track I made, every road I went down, amen, every turn I made down through life. Hey, the Lord Jesus Christ was there with me. He loved me all the way. And listen, he was patient with me until he got me, listen, until he converted me to Christianity. And I thank God for all that. Listen, we ought to praise him for his love today. We sit back today and think, man, I know we got a Savior, but I don't think it's worth all that. You ought to get over that. Amen. I'm glad I got somebody I can praise. I'm glad somebody loved me that much. Amen. I'm glad that I know that I got a place I'm going to go to when I leave here called glory. Amen. I'm glad there was a day and a night in my life. Matter of fact, the very pastor that led me to the Lord texted me this morning. Talking about how much he loved me. Wishing me a Merry Christmas. I seen him at Bojangles today. I love him. I love him. I appreciate what he did. I appreciate him taking his time, taking the Word of God, sitting down with me at 10 o'clock at night in my living room, showing me what I must do to be born again and telling me that Jesus loved me. And listen, he's been a mentor in my life. He's backed me year after year and time after time and encouraged me all along the way. I'm thankful that somebody loves me today. In those times when I don't even think Jane loves me, I'm glad God does. Amen. I told in our Sunday school class this morning, we were talking about how sin separates our fellowship with God. I said, I need God too much to separate my fellowship. Sometimes I need him. Amen. Even in the midnight hour, I need him. Around the house, I need him. When I think she don't love me, I'm glad he does. Amen. I thank God for it. Listen, I'm going to live with her for a while down here. I hope many more years, but I'm going to live with him for eternity over there. Listen, I thank God for it. We ought to find a reason to praise him this morning. We ought to find a reason to worship him. We ought to find a reason to adore him. First of all, we ought to surrender to him. Then we ought to shout the praises of a powerful Savior. Yeah. Listen to this. This is what got me the other day, preacher. I never seen this. God showed me this on Thursday. I was sitting in my office reading. Not only did she surrender to a personal Savior, she shouted the praise of a powerful Savior. She saw the promises of a holy God. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. I got cold chills when I saw this the other day. She saw the promises of a holy God. Listen, Dad, listen, we've got some reasons to rejoice, amen. We got some reasons to rejoice over his birth. I begin to look at this right here and how all the promise of God down through the years. And I ain't got time to go into all of them today, but listen, God had helped Israel, there's no doubt. If you study the life of Israel, and I love Old Testament history, amen. I love to go back and see how God worked through the life of Israel. You know what it proves to me? That God's going to work through my life too, amen. Listen, if he brought them through the trials he brought him through, he brought them out of bondage and out of destruction, he brought them through the wilderness, amen. And listen, everything that he done, listen, I know God will bring us through. Listen, God helped Israel down through the years. He was merciful to Israel down through the years. And listen, God kept his promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And the Bible says if he kept his promise to them, he's going to keep his promise to me, amen. And Mary here, listen, began to see the promises of God fulfilled in her life. This same God she'd read about, this same God she'd heard about, this same God where Israel had talked about all these years and all the great things that God had done, and now Mary gets to see the promises of God himself fulfilled in her life. What were those promises? The Bible says in Isaiah 7:14 that he would be born of a virgin. She gets to see that. Amen. She gets to see that promise, amen, that a Savior is going to be born of a virgin. She's the one asked the question, I don't know how it's going to be. I've never laid down with a man before. And listen, my life is clear. My body is clean. Amen. God, I've never done that. But listen, if you say it's going to happen, I'm going to lay it down and here it is. Do what you got to do. Amen. And she gets to see that promise fulfilled in her life. I'm going to tell you what, friend. It is great to see the promises of God fulfilled in our life. Listen, look up here. You're looking at a promise today. If you're saved today, you're promised today. Amen. God, listen, God fulfilled that promise in her life. Mary got to see the promises of a holy God. The Bible says he'd be born in Bethlehem. Mary got to see that. Amen. We've been in the stable there in Bethlehem. And it ain't nothing like you and I ever see around here. I can tell you that now. But it's a glorious thing to walk into. It'll humble you just to walk in the stable and see a stable where you think that Jesus may have been born. And what it looked like. He came down to a lowly manger and got born in a stable with the cattle. Amen. Listen, and Mary got to see that promise fulfilled in her life. God said it was going to happen. The Bible said it was going to happen. It was written that it was going to happen. And Mary got to see that promise. Why? I'll tell you why. Because she surrendered to a personal Savior. That's why she got to see those promises. Listen, you're never going to get to see the promise of God till you surrender. There's some promises that people are going to miss out on and they'll never get to see because they won't surrender to God. Amen. There's some of your people you may not ever be that may not ever be saved. You'll never get to see saved because we don't surrender. They don't have a witness to them. Amen. There's churches going to die off. I will tell you this. Churches will die off because churches will not surrender to a holy God. And therefore, they'll not see the promise of God. Listen, God promised us great things on this earth. Amen. Listen, he promised church. Listen, he said he would be born in Bethlehem. She saw that. Listen, the Bible said that he was going to die for the sins of the world. He was going to die for sinners. Guess who witnessed that? Mary witnessed that promise. She saw the promise of God. Amen. She saw it there in Bethlehem. She saw it that he would be born of a virgin. She saw it that he would die for sinners. Not only that, God said he would rise again. Amen. I'm thankful for that. Listen, I'm glad I don't serve a dead Savior today. I'm glad I serve one that's alive today. Listen, you walk in most churches and you think they're serving a dead Savior. Man, I've been in some of them and I'm thinking, I don't know where your God is. Hey, listen, he's back down in the coffin somewhere, but I'm glad mine's alive and he's on the throne. I'm glad I can worship him today. Listen, I'm glad I can witness for him. I'm glad that he is alive and well today. He's not standing in the bread line somewhere today. He's alive and well in us today. Amen. But she got to witness those promises, the promise of God. Listen, God will always, you listen to this, God will always keep his promises. We may not be able to keep all of our promises, but God will always keep his promises. There's some things, let me just say this. There's some things that I don't promise my wife because I don't feel like I can keep them. There's things she's asked me to do before that I said no. I'm not going to make you that promise because I may fail. I may fail that promise, and I know that, right? And I'll do the best that I can. And then Jane said, I told y'all the other day, Wednesday night, about going shopping the other day. Your husbands listen to me. And Jane said, here's what she told me the other day. She said, last Sunday, she says, Dad, I want you to do something for me. And I said, okay, what is it? She said, I want you to go with me shopping. That's murder. I mean, she said, my daughter called me the other afternoon to check on me. And she said, I want you to go with me shopping. I want you to drop me off at the door. I want you to pick me up when I'm ready. I want you to take my bags to the car. You know, I want you to take me out to eat. I want you to do all this. And if I want to go back to a store two or three times, I want to be able to go back, and I don't want you to say nothing. Try making that promise. I was good until the last part. Don't say nothing. But I made her a promise. And then I prayed all day Monday. I went to the gym Tuesday morning, worked out all my frustration, went back home and saddled up and said, let's go. And we made it all day long. Well, come Wednesday, she said, Daddy, I'm going to Burlington tomorrow. I said, good luck. You're on your own. I'm out of this one right here. Ain't going to happen. Brother Rob, she's told me this for years, and I always ask her what she wants for Christmas. And by the way, I did not. Y'all buy her something for Christmas because I didn't buy her nothing. Y'all ought to feel sorry for her and get her something for Christmas. She's a pastor's wife. Look up here. Take care of her. I mean, give her all kind of gift cards and go out and eat and all that stuff we can do. No, I'm just kidding. She's got me, Brother Gene. She tells me for Christmas, and we'll get to talking, she'll say, here's what I want. She said, I want you for 2 whole weeks. 2 whole weeks. You at my beck and command? No, absolutely not. I've never given her that gift yet. I live with her all year long. I appreciate our marriage too much. I love her way too much to make that promise. Amen. 2 whole weeks, y'all. I'm a pastor. It's not in me. If y'all still want me to pastor the church, I can't do that. Amen. Because I'm gonna tell you, there'll be a divorce after the first 3 days. Amen. I could not handle it. We have to be careful with promises. I love you, Mom, and you know that. Amen. I promise you, there's some things she ain't gonna promise me either. Amen. But listen, and I just killed a lot of them. Amen. But anyway, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, I'm glad that Mary got to see the promises fulfilled. Can I tell you today, church, the only way you and I are going to ever see the promises of God fulfilled in our life and in the church is to surrender to God, fully to God, and learn how to shout His praises. We have to get to a point in our life where we recognize that He's alive. He's alive, and that He's never stopped fulfilling promises. He will never stop fulfilling promises in our life. He came here to fulfill a promise. Listen, and He will continue to fulfill promises in our life. I wrote John this down just this morning. Listen, I'm a promise, amen. You're a promise. If you're here today, you're saved, you're a promise. He promised, listen, that whoever sought after Him, amen. Listen, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, whosoever believed in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He came to seek and to save that which was lost. If you're in here today, you're a promise. This church is a promise, amen. Not only that, eternity is a promise. Our Savior is a promise. Salvation is a promise. And He never stops keeping His promises in life. And I'm thankful that I get to witness the promises of God. I want to sing a couple more songs today. I want to sing a song, Here He Lives. Page 188 in your hymnals, page 188, He Lives today. And then we're going to go to 329, Standing on the Promises. Listen to the Word of God today. Listen to the song, He Lives.
All right, 188, He Lives. We'll sing the first verse there.
Sing it like you mean it today.
All right, 329, Standing on the Promises.
Amen.
329.
Wouldn't it be good to see your promises? Amen. Amen. Your promise today, if you're saved. Amen.
One more song. There's a booklet in the back of your pew right there,
And the song is entitled, Do You Hear What I Hear? And part of that, it says, Do You See What I See? Amen. Listen, Mary surrendered to a personal Savior. She shouted praises to a powerful Savior. And then she saw the promises of a holy God. It is our day to worship Him. He is a powerful Savior today. He is a personal Savior today. And I don't know about you, but I pray that you can see what I see. I pray that you can hear what I hear. I pray that you'll understand and see the promise of God in your life. You say, man, I want my family to get saved. God said He'll save them. That's a promise. I want my children to get saved. God said He'll save them. That's a promise. God said, I want the church to grow and multiply. That's a promise from God. If it does not happen, it'll be because of us. I pray that you can hear what I hear. I pray that you can see what I see. I'm going to get Jane. Jane, if you would come up here. Jane's going to help lead this one right here because she knows it better for the choir. But all you choir out there, there's a lot of you may have to share your books. Here's a time to get close. Amen. Get close with your neighbor. Get close with your church family. Sing it, listen, sing it like you mean it today. And here's what we're going to do. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to use this for an invitation song today. And listen to me. If you're here today and you don't know Him as a personal Savior, if you'll come forward during this song, we'll grab a Bible and show you what you must do to be born again. If you cannot shout the praises of a powerful Savior, if I were you, I would come and ask God to restore to me the joy of my salvation. I'd get rid of some things in my life. I'd clean up some things in my life. Listen, cleanliness is next to godliness. Amen. Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way by taking heed to the word of God. I'd come and get a hold of the word of God, get a hold of the feet of God this morning at the foot of the cross. Say, God, clean me up. I want to be able to rejoice that I serve a risen Savior. I want to be able to adore You. I want to be able to worship You. And God, I want to see the promises fulfilled. Amen. I want to look around and see. Listen, all you got to do is look around this building. Rob, you a promise today. Listen, let me just say this. A friend of mine called me. I don't know how long Rob and him been here. Now it's been a good while. But I happened to see a friend of mine. And here's what he asked me. He said, I hear Rob Carter's going to your church. And he knows who I'm talking about. I said, he is. He said, Mike, he said, do you know how long I witnessed to that man at work? He said, I witnessed you try to win him to the Lord. And listen, he was so excited that, listen, through his witness, and Rob remembers the witness. There's no question about it. He's a miracle. He's a promise that God said it could happen. Candace, you're a promise today. Her mom and dad was praying for her way before she ever got here. Lived off upstate with all them Yankees up there. God help her. It's a promise she's down here. It's a miracle. Amen. Listen, her mom and dad. I remember the time they prayed for her. Wept over her. Brandon. Weeping over their children. Their promise because God said it could happen. Their promise. Virginia, your boys are a promise. You pray over them. Their promise. God said it can happen. Listen, we got to hear. There's two things about the gospel. You've heard me say this a bunch of times. Number one, blood joy's got to be preached. Number two, it's got to be heard. A man can preach the gospel all he wants to, but if man never hears it, it don't do him any good. It must be preached and it must be heard. Why? Romans 10, 17, faith coming by hearing and hearing by the word of God. And listen, God would love nothing no more. You look up at me. God would love nothing no more than to fulfill a promise in this place this morning. We celebrate His birth. Christmas Eve, as we celebrate the birth of Christ. If everyone come forward and say, listen, preacher, I don't know Him as a personal Savior, but I'd love to today. That's going to be the fulfillment of a promise. Preacher, I'm saved, but I can't shout. My life ain't. Listen, God said He would cleanse it. Amen. Confess your faults one to another. Confess your sins to Christ. Listen, He'll cleanse them. Amen. That's all He's asking. He just wants to fulfill a promise. But you're going to have to hear God today. You're going to have to see what Mary saw. Listen, you're going to have to get what Mary got. If you get what Mary got, there'll be a personal surrender. If you get what Mary got, listen, there'll be praises to a powerful Savior. If you get what Mary got, you'll be able to see the promises of a holy God. Help us sing your song today. Help us sing, Mama. I want you to listen to what it says just before we sing it. I begin to read it here. Said the king to the people everywhere, listen to what I say. It is the king today. It's not about what I say. It's about what he says. And friend, today, if we'll listen to the king, listen, we can have what Mary had. We can get what Mary got. And it will be a personal surrender. It will be a powerful praise to a holy God. And we will get to see the promises of God fulfilled in our life. Let's sing this last verse right here. Listen, sing it loud today. Listen to the King. We serve a holy God today. I began to look at this on Thursday, and I'm going to tell you what, boy, God got a hold of my heart. I began to look at how much this resembled salvation and the Holy Ghost dealing with you and I. I'm thankful today that I have a personal Savior. I'm thankful today that I can give praises to a personal God. Amen. And I'm thankful today that I get to see the promises of a holy God fulfilled. Every time there's someone saved, every time there's a healing. I went to the hospital. Michael and I went to the hospital on Friday afternoon to visit our neighbor, Barry, over there. They had the stroke. It's been about 5 weeks ago today, I think it is. And every time I go, there's a little more improvement. They didn't give him much hope to begin with, but then on Friday, he called Michael's name. Amen. And he was trying to talk to us, and he was done walked all the way around the hall over there on Friday. Listen, we serve a big God. God said he would heal whom he will. Amen. We get to see the promises of a holy God. And I'm thankful that we still live in a day and an hour that God still works. He's not done. He's not finished. Amen. He's still saving souls. Amen. He's still healing people. And I thank God for that. He's still a merciful God. You ought to praise him today just because he still loves you. You ought to praise him today just because he's mighty. You ought to praise him today because of his grace. We ought to praise him today because of his goodness. Amen. Well, we ought to praise him today, listen, just because his love toward us today. Listen, we have found favor in his sight today. You realize we have the favor of God just to be here today? We have found favor in his sight. Boy, we love you today. When you get what Mary got, things will be different in your life. Amen. Christmas will mean so much more. Jane was in the bathroom this morning, and I don't know how she hears on Sunday morning after she listens to that music rings rings out, and I just get in the den in there, and I just get the glory in it listening to the songs. And today we begin to list those things. I just wept and cried, thanking God, you're a great God, and I thank you for loving me. I'm thankful that he loved me enough to die for me, amen, that he came to this earth for me and lived on this earth, walked this earth, and he died for me that I could have life. Eternity is a promise. It's a promise. I pray today that you know him as a personal Savior. I pray today that you can praise him as a powerful God. I pray today that you can see the promises of a holy God. We love you today. No service tonight. Have fun with your kids and your family over the next couple of days. Enjoy Christmas time. Don't forget about Christ and what we truly represent. Every time, listen, we've been going to the hospital visit, and you know, you walk out somebody, everything is happy holiday. Well, everything means Merry Christmas. Yeah. You know, and everybody say, I'm like, y'all have a Merry Christmas, happy holidays. Y'all have a Merry Christmas, happy holiday, you know, from them. I'm like, no, we're going to have a Merry Christmas. Amen. I'll tell it again. Listen, if it ain't Christ's birthday, go back to work. Don't accept your bonus. Don't accept your Christmas gift. Go back to work. Let the rest of it enjoy our holiday. You ain't going to bother me at all, amen, because it is about him, and I thank God for it. We love you today. Thank you for being in the house of God. Thank you for listening to me today. I pray it's been a help to you today. Enjoy your Christmas holiday, and I'll not see you on Wednesday night. Jane and I are going to be gone for a few days this week, Lord willing.